Hey Shelby Bells, it's Shelby. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in for another video. In today's video, you guys, the podcast came out. The Keemstar, FaZe Banks, Trisha Paytas podcast has been released on Spotify, girl. And, well, we have to talk about it. So if you're interested in hearing more about that drama, then make sure that you keep on watching. Spotify, just so you guys know, you can't get it anywhere else. And I listened to, I'll be honest, I did not listen to the whole thing, okay? Don't come for me, but I did listen to it. The ring light went out, you guys. Hello, the ring light went out. Hello. Okay. And well, I didn't listen to the whole thing. I listened to some of it and I have some thoughts. So my thoughts were, it was, maybe a little boring. I don't know. I don't mean that to say that Trisha was boring or FaZe was boring or Keem was boring, because in their own entities, I mean, they are entertainers, they're very successful, whatever. But I just felt like it was very much, I thought it was gonna get a lot juicier than it did. I was hoping that Trisha would go off and be like, I can't believe you, Keemstar. I hate you, Keemstar. You are mean to Ethan. Ethan is my family. And you know, I'm on team Ethan, and I, joke's on you, buddy. I came on this podcast so I could clown on you and I can make you look like an idiot to everybody in the whole wide world, because I'm on team H3. I'm on team Ethan. My name is Trisha Paytas and I am on team Ethan. I am not on team Keemstar. So if you have a problem with that, then that's fine. But that's why I came on this podcast, to prove you wrong, honey. And I thought that was gonna be like what was gonna happen. And while she did kind of stick up for Ethan, Trisha was very much like, you know, like, well, I think that Ethan was, I'm on team Ethan, but like, I don't know, like, I'm happy to be squashing the beef here and da, 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 da. I was hoping it would get a lot juicier than it did. And it just kind of didn't, you know. One part that really stuck out to me, and I felt like Keem was kind of like trying to poke the bear a little bit with Trish and get Trish to like kind of explode again with all of this stuff, is that Keem kind of like reiterated to Trish that he thought the reason that the last episode of Frenemies wasn't aired was because Ethan didn't want to look like he was in the wrong, and that Keemstar said that Ethan can like never be wrong in any situation, and so that's why that whole, you know, thing happened or whatever. And I mean, I don't know, I thought that was kind of like poking the bear, and it wouldn't be surprising to me if Keem actually flipped this around and started to troll Trish to get Trish to fly off the rails, because he's just that kind of person, it seems like to me. I don't know. But I wonder what Ethan's response is gonna be. What do you think Ethan's gonna say now that the podcast came out? That's very interesting to me, because I'm like, I don't know, like, is he gonna be like, okay, well, Trish didn't trash me, like, everything's cool now? Or is he gonna be like, I still can't believe she's on the podcast, and like, you're not invited to Thanksgiving anymore? Like, how do you think that's gonna happen, you know? Like, Trish did say that they don't communicate directly now, and like they communicate like, oh, well, Ethan said, Trish, hey, Ethan said this. Oh, well, tell him that I said this. And that's kind of like how they're communicating right now, which is a little bit like, they need to work that out, you guys. They need to be on speaking terms, their family. This whole thing is super, super messy, but I feel like, I don't know, I just feel like they need to at least be like on talking terms. Like, they can't just be like, hey, Moses, tell Ethan that I said this. And then Ethan can't be like, Ela, tell Trish that I said this. You know, it can't be like that. It can't be like that. We need to be adults about the situation, and we need to communicate. Like, we have to be able to communicate. You know what I'm saying? Okay, guys. So, update. Ethan Klein has responded. He made an H3 podcast off the rails episode called I'm Done with Trisha Paytas. It was published about 18 hours or 19 hours ago at the time of that I'm filming this video, and it's currently sitting at 1.1 million views. And you guys, I'm telling you, Ethan, he came with the receipts, he came with the facts, he dug up old clips from Frenemies, from Trisha's videos, from the podcast that Keemstar and Trisha did. Ethan really, really came with the receipts,
kind of, you know, calling out all of Trisha's hypocrisies and all of this. And I'm, listen, I am not an anti-Trisha Paytas person. I'm also not an Ethan Klein person. The more I hear about Keemstar, the more I'm almost an anti-Keemstar person, but I'm trying to stay impartial to all of this stuff. But Keemstar just seems like a really, really crappy human being. I'm looking at it. I paused the podcast to film this little segment of the video for you guys because I just need to say this stuff. But apparently on August 7th, Keemstar tweeted out, "I'm loving this W streak while my enemies are on anti-depression medicine, going to therapists and gaining so much weight, they're about to lose their left foot to diabetes. Stay mad and fat." Like, if that's the kind of stuff that Keemstar is post, or like, and I've seen other things that Keemstar has posted in the past and stuff, Keemstar just seems like a really disgusting person to me. And I don't know, like, maybe we are anti-Keemstar. I mean, I just can't, like, I don't know. He just seems like a really, really crappy, insecure person, you know? Then again, you guys, I'm basing this right after watching this podcast where Ethan is going in on Keemstar. So we have to, you know, remember that or whatever. But I mean, I just kind of think that Keem might be the real, like, horrible person in the situation. I just really think that Trisha needs help, and Trisha needs to, you know, have somebody kind of like help her, or like tell her when to stop, or like whatever. I don't know. I mean, like, she did build her career on controversy and all this stuff, but now it's just kind of hitting a little too close to home with this being her family and like Moses and stuff. And here's the thing. Moses is a great person, it seems like. Ela is a great person, it seems like. I'm not saying Ethan isn't. The more I see from Ethan, you know what? Back in the day, I really didn't vibe with some of Ethan's jokes. I thought they were insensitive. But the more that I watched him, I started to feel more that he was kind of like a genuine person. Here's the thing. I don't know. I mean, I just don't know. With Ethan and Trisha, I'm going to stay impartial on it, okay? But what I will say is that after this podcast came out that Ethan just put out about the "I'm done with Trisha Paytas," I have to say that Ethan made some really, really, really good points in it about the hypocrisy of the things that Trisha Paytas was saying, of even just the entirety of her going on the Mama's Basement podcast, okay? And I highly encourage you guys to watch this episode of the H3 podcast. I mean, it's really, really well done. It has humor in it, as they always do. And, you know, it's juicy, straight up. It's juicy. It's tea. If you want to hear some tea, if you want to hear some hot gossip, if you want to hear somebody really go there, then, well, listen to this podcast, because it really is very, it's entertainment. Okay. As far as this stuff goes with their family and everything, Ela seems like an amazing person. Moses seems like an amazing person. And I think that where I stand in this, after all of this is said and done right now, is that this needs to stop for them, right? Donna Klein has inserted herself into things. That's Ethan's mom. She has inserted herself into things at this point, and she said things that make me be like, okay, girl, well, you're just trying to, you know, I don't know what you're trying to do, but you've inserted yourself and said some nasty things yourself. Moses has never said anything nasty. Ela has never said anything nasty. And it's just unfortunate that these two people have to be in the middle of this stuff with their family, because at the end of the day, Moses loves Trisha, Ela loves Ethan. And when, you know, Ela and Ethan are family, obviously they're married. Moses and Trisha are going to be family. They're getting married. And it's just like, just having this much beef with the family. Yeah, families beef. There's issues with families in real life. You know, not every family is just like, you know, super tight and super close and all of that. And I get it. You know, it's just unfortunate that we see all of this stuff unfolding on the internet, you know, and the Keemstar thing and the Ethan Klein thing, they are just never going to be cool. And Keemstar's done some really, really crappy things to Ethan Klein, but also Ethan has said some really, really awful things about Keemstar on the internet. You know, it goes both ways with them. But Keemstar, I think overall, at least more recently, you know, I don't know about Ethan Klein's past, but at least more recently, Keemstar has a history of just being like a really kind of like a shitty person, right? And so, I mean, I don't know. That's just kind of where I'm at with this all right now. It's really,
I don't know, you guys, it's giving me a headache, to be quite honest with you.
I'm going to finish watching this podcast, but I did want to insert a little clip here for you guys and let you know that Ethan has responded, and I highly, highly recommend you go check out that podcast, I'm Done with Trisha Paytas, Off the Rails, number 8. It was published August 19th, and it's sitting at 1.1 million views right now. As of this time that I'm filming this video, Trisha has not responded to Ethan's podcast he posted about this. So we will see what happens with that, and I'll definitely keep you updated. But I just had to interject real quick and let you guys know that there was an update after the time that I filmed this video originally.
But what do you guys think about my eyeshadow look? I literally am obsessed with this eyeshadow look. It is, I've been wearing this palette literally nonstop. I cannot stop. When I get hooked on a palette, I will just wear it and wear it and wear it. This is the KKW X Winnie palette. I've talked about it before, but I just have to talk about it again. So it's Kim Kardashian X Winnie Harlow, who I didn't know who Winnie Harlow was until last night when I was watching Making the Cut. Do you guys watch Making the Cut? Oh my God, such an iconic show, so fun. The first episode I watched was like Heidi Klum wearing like head to toe Valentino, and she had these gorgeous Valentino earrings on, and like, oh my God, just, it was such a fun show. And Winnie Harlow is, I don't know if she's a guest judge or like a real, like a permanent judge, I really don't know because I've only seen one episode, but Winnie Harlow ex Kim Kardashian, and it is such a fun palette, oh my God. So it's like a lot of neutrals, which, let's just be honest, in my everyday life, I'm not running around here in like lime green eyeshadow, you know what I'm saying? So it's, but the shimmers are so pretty. My favorite shimmer in this entire palette is this brown one right here. And I'll just swatch that for you guys. It is literally the prettiest thing. Oh my God. It's just the prettiest shimmer shade ever. I love it. It applies like butter. It's really, really good. The only other, I'm really particular about my shimmer shades, and the palette that I love the most for the shimmer shades, to be honest with you, is the original Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette. Love the shimmer quality in that. And this one actually like really compares to that, which is, I don't know, kind of a weird thing, but I kind of base like how I like my shimmers off of those shimmers, to be honest with you. And this is just really, really good. So I love that palette so much. And I'm also wearing my Kiss Me Now Cosmetics Rich Luxe Wonky Lashes. So these are actually, there's still a few available. So if you want to pick those up, make sure you go to kissmenowcosmetics.com. Use code Shelby to save 10% on your Kiss Me Now Cosmetics lashes. They're the Rich Luxe Wonky Lashes. You can save 10% on anything on their website. They have fantastic makeup brushes and stuff too. I use this one for powder all the time. Really nice soft bristles on here, and they're so cute with the little pink diamonds on them and stuff. Oh my God. Really, really cute brand in general. Latina owned, Houston based brand. Super, super cute. Love them so much. But anyway, you guys, I think that's gonna be it. I think that's all the tea I have in this video. Let me know all of your thoughts on the Keemstar, Trisha Paytas, FaZe Banks, Mom's Basement podcast. Let me know all of your thoughts on how the podcast went in the comment section down below. I'd love to hear from you. And if you love today's video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel down below. Don't forget to ring the bell so you're notified of all my future videos when they do post. Remember that all Shelby bells ring the bell. And you can follow me on all my social media at Beauty by Shelby. That's S-H-E-L-B-Y-E, all at Beauty by Shelby. I'll leave that right up there on the screen for you so you can see it. If you're enjoying the Beauty by Shelby vibes and want to see more, then YouTube should be suggesting a couple videos down below for you to choose from. So I would love it if you did that. But if you're just here to catch up on the Trisha Paytas, Keemstar, Mom's Basement podcast drama, totally cool too, girl. Appreciate your view. Love you so. Thank you so much for watching today's video, you guys. And I will see you in, oh, this is hard to open. Oh! See you in the next one. Bye, guys.